Hi folks, this is Rose from In Rose's Garden, and today we are going to work on a couple of hair barrettes. Now one of these is a custom order and the other one is just an extra one. I designed them both at the same time, so I figured we could make them both today. A hair barrette is not hard to make. It just takes time because the glue has to dry, and but they are so fun and pretty. So let's turn down and I'll show you what we're going to do. Okay, we've got the pieces for both here. This one is going to be a medium-sized one. It's slightly smaller than a large, which is 3 inches. See, that's the difference. And this is the one pieces for the large. Now I've got my E6000 out. That's what I use to glue my pieces together. And we'll need our bracelet bender. Now you don't have to use a bracelet bender. Before I got my bracelet bender, I did all my bending by hand. So what we're going to do is, this one's actually almost in place. We've got two brass pieces here. Actually they're bronze. I have only painted the two purple flowers on this one, but I have painted some green and purple on this one. This is going to sit on the top of this one. Then we're going to put the bear here on one side, like so. And this flower and little leaf on the other side. Now, if I decide it needs something more, I will put a jewel right here in this big middle spot. But right now, this is what we're going to do. So that's the medium one. Now, the large one, we're going to have one of these pieces also. I didn't paint these background pieces, however. We're going to take this piece. It's going to go over the top here and this one here. Then we're going to have a bear down here. And a bear up here. Come here, bear. Then we're going to have one of these flower sprigs going this way, and another one going this way. Then we're going to put one of these purple flowers down here, and another one up here. So this is what our large one is going to look like. Let's get it over here a little. I see I'm out of the camera just about. There we go. So we'll take our little pieces off, and then the first thing we want to do is get our big pieces bent to work on our bender bar, our top of our blank here. And we'll do that with both. Here, you guys come down here. Well, no, I'm going to use the... So we need to bend all of the pieces so they fit onto the bar, so they touch down to it. So we'll take our bender, our bracelet bender, and just start bending. Now that we've got that bent, we've got to see how it's fitting on the onto the barrette piece. So we'll hold it down where it would be and see. I've got this side's up a little bit, though actually the other side's pretty fine. So we'll take this. Okay, that's pretty good. Though you can see it still seems to want to pop up just a hair's breadth on this side, but not too bad. So now that we've got that set, we need to do the other two pieces. So just bend them. And I'm going to bend both before we start forming them onto the bar. Now we'll take our bar and we'll see how these work. This is going to sit about right here. This one looks good, so that goes fine. There we go. So this one's ready to glue these pieces on. Now let's get the other one bent and ready to go. Now you'll notice I've put this on this pink mat. This is a silicone mat, and so I use that to protect my regular mat because the glue, of course, will make a mess if you get it onto your regular mat, but it will peel right off of this once it dries a little bit. So here are these two bent. Now we have to see how they fit. Looks pretty good. See how you can't see much air between the two pieces? And now we'll check out this one. Now this one has a little more air, you can see right there. Not too badly, but a little bit. So there we go now. They're ready to glue onto our bar. Both bunches. So we can start with either one. We'll just start here with our medium one here. And what we do is I'm going to put some of the E6000 right along the base here. And I'm going to close this because it's going to want to keep coming out. Then you just center this onto here. Like that. And then we will put our little one on as well. Now this covers the whole of the other one, so you can put glue everywhere. Sometimes if it's not going to cover everywhere, you'll want to just be real careful with your glue and just put it in the spots where it's going to cover the other one. This one, it doesn't matter because it's everywhere. So now we'll flip this and center it on top of the other piece, which means it needs to go this way just a hair's breadth and down. And see, it wants to pop up some. We don't want it to do that. So what we're going to do, and it slid here, that's where we don't want it. There we go. So we want it there and here. So now we're going to get out some little clothespins. I always have some sitting beside my desk that I've been using, but most of these feel like they're already need to be thrown out. There's one. They will glue themselves together. And of course, then they don't work worth beans. See if this is in the right spot. Looks like it. A little glue on my finger, so we'll get that off. Now, if you have enough space after you get these things all put down, you can always put your smaller pieces on right away, but I don't know if they will fit yet, so we will find out in just a moment. So now we'll just sit this side right here for a little while, and we'll put the other one together. So bottom piece first, and we'll do this exactly like we did the other one by just gluing the base piece here. Down. Now this one, of course, is bigger, so this piece will not cover the whole of, well, it will make it right to the edges of both. See how that is? And that's one of the reasons why we're going to use the other piece as well. But this does not need to have glue right here at this very base here, or right here on these very outer edges right here. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the glue here. And here. Then we'll put it in place like so. Now we're going to do the same with the other one. And again, we don't need the glue on the outer edges or the little, what looks sort of like a crown piece there. Now you'll see some of the glue is coming through, and that's all right because I'm going to E6000, you can pluck little bits, extra bits off as long as you catch it in time. If you don't catch it in time, then it will dry up too hard. But it needs to be dry enough that it won't glob either, so get all sticky and stuff. You need it to dry that for about 15 minutes, maybe 20, but 15 to 20 minutes is good. Now I have some more clips, some more these, so we're going to start gluing this together. See, this is slid sideways some. We don't want that. So we need to glue to hold these down so that they don't go everywhere. It's another thing that 15 minutes helps this glue set in place, so you don't have to worry about your pieces moving around. Before they dry some, they will move, which can be a royal pain because, well, we don't want them to move. So now we have our second, the large one, ready to sit for a while. And if you have room, you can start putting your pieces on. Like, see, the little bear has room here. I could put him on right now. And the other one would go over here. So I think this pin might be in the way for this one to go up where it should. Which I can move. And our bear could sit right here. And the flowers will go over here and over here. So I think I am going to glue the two bears on because the room is there for putting them on, because we're going to put the flowers in the other two in the other spots. So get our bears loose here and just put some E6000 on them. And carefully put them in the spot you want them at. Now it feels like I should have bent that bear a little bit, so I'm gonna try and bend this one just a teeny bit. I don't want it a lot, but it'll sit down better if I have it bent just a hair's breadth. So I just bent this one. I didn't bend him very much, just a hair's breadth. And we can put him in place. And since we are messing with the bears, I'm going to see if I feel that this one needs a bend too. Yeah, a little bit. So we'll bend him just a little bit. So I'll put him in and, oops, he slid out too much. Squish down. See, it's just got a teeny bend now, not very much, just a little bit. And he's going to go back on this side of the barrette. This one actually needs some bending, so I'm going to pull him off. And I'm going to try and bend him a little bit by hand because I don't want the glue on my pliers. My fingers will come off. It'll come off of easier. Not sure if I got him to bend or not. Okay. Now, since the glue's still sitting there, we'll put him back in place and see if he sits a little better. Yeah, his head could be down just a little bit more, but I think he's all right now. Much better than he was. So wipe all this glue off of my fingers with a nice paper towel, which I always keep beside me. And we do want this bear to lift up a little bit more than that they have than he's there. So let's see if I can get it to, oh, there we go. That'll work fine. So we'll pull this little guy off and glue him. And then put him in place. Actually, I think we might be able to put this one together all the way. Well, I'm going to want this here. We'll put this little purple flower here. Now, if you don't want glue on your hands and you want to make a hair barrette, I would advise getting some surgical gloves, you know, medical gloves, and using those. I always get glue on myself. I know I'm going to, so I don't worry about it happening. Come on, little leaf, come off my finger. There we go. Now you'll notice I got a little glue right there. So what I'm going to do, because that is dry, it came off my finger, is I'm going to take my tweezers. And this is how we're going to handle all of our little glue blobs, because we will have them. And we're going to take our tweezers and just pluck that off. Now, in a bit, I'm going to check and see how dry our pieces are here and see if we can take our clips off. And at that time, we will, of course, pick any excess glue out. So, how I do that is I take it out and then I give it a wiggle and see if it'll move. This one did move some. So I will probably put the clips back, but first I'm going to see if I can, how well the glue is going to pull off of here, the excess. If it's not going to be easy, then it needs to dry for a little bit more. If it comes off easily, like it just plucks right out, you're at that optimum time. We're almost there, but just not quite. And this one, other than if I decide to put a crystal here, is finished. And I may decide to put that crystal there. So we will reapply our clothespins, our baby clothespins, so that this baby stays in place. And we will let him sit and dry for a while. Now let's see how we're doing over here. This one seems to be pretty good, which is sort of surprising since we did this one, I believe, second to that one. But this one, on the other hand, could stay squeezed down for a little bit. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the other pieces on, then I'll put the pins back on to tighten that back up. So let's get our pieces on. These two are going to go up here in either corner, this direction. Let's see here. The flower is going to sit down below, like so, on him and above on him. So, look over here some more. So let's get our glue and glue these pieces on, and then we will re-bobby pin it, clothes pin it, so that it stays good and tight while it finishes drying. And we'll see if we feel we need to pluck some glue, so to speak. Right now, like I said, I'm just going to put these little guys on. This one goes right here. Now there we go, our pieces are now glued in. And now what I'm gonna do is, see how this is popping up a little bit? It definitely needs its clip back in place. So we'll go over both sides, and because the flower's trying to stick up, we're going to put one of the pins over the top of the flower to hold it, the flower sprig, to hold it down nice to the edge here. We're going to do the same with the other side, even though it seems to be a little tighter down than this one is. I think we'll put a couple more pins on here to hold the top up here better, to make sure it doesn't slide any. And then it can be set aside until it dries enough to pluck some of the glue out. So let's take another look at this one, see how it's doing. And I think I am going to find a crystal to put in the middle there. Now I think I've decided on a green one, since we're in the forest and this is the forest floor, and we've got lots of other purple things. So we're going to pull a green one out of here. And I've got a nice big green one right here, which I think will, oops, come back here you. Go nicely right there. So we need to put a bit of glue right there on that and stick our crystal on. This one will get no crystals. I don't feel that it needs them. It's got plenty of other things on it to take care of where, you know, a crystal would sit. We've got other items in place, so I think we're good without a crystal on that one at all. So we'll pull this crystal off of here. Just put a dab of E6000 there. Not very much, just a teeny touch. Just more or less just to touch it, like so. Now it wants to drip. Close that up. Because frankly, we're done with it. Now we'll get our crystal and put it right there in the middle. Tap it down. And there she is. So now we're going to wait for a little bit and see if we're going to need to pull any glue out. But they need to sit for a few more minutes, I think. So let's test it, see if we need to pull any glue off. Oops, I bumped the crystal with my thumb and moved it. In the middle there, okay. There is some glue right in this hollow here, but I'm not sure it makes any difference because it's not glopping up. It's just filled the hollow, so I'm not going to bug with that one. I think that side looks pretty good. So we'll put its clip back on to hold it just in case it isn't really dry, but it looks pretty dry to me. Then we will just carefully pick off the rest, see if there's any gluey messes anywhere I need to pick up. Looks like no. There was a piece of glitter on that one. Okay. This is the place that we were needing to pull stuff off before. See how now it's sort of rubbery and it just pulls up? Don't forget to wipe this off of your tweezers as you work, because if you don't get it off of your tweezers when it dries, it will be permanently there. Just got a little bit more to pull out, and I think we're good. So you see how there's a big, there's a globby looking spot right here. We want to get hold of that piece and pull it out. So I may go from this side because there we go. Now it's out. Looks good. See how that's now cleaned up? I'm going to put this pin back in place. And we're going to let it dry. Needs to dry for a while more before we take the pins off. And then it has to dry for another 24 hours yet before you can do anything with it. So let's carefully pull these pins back, see if I need to remove any glue for extra glue from them. See the little tiny blobs right here? That's pretty good. That's all right. I think I noticed a bit right in this hollow right here, so pull it out. Okay. Let's see under here. That looks good. Right here. Good. Okay, I think everything is gonna be fine. I think there's a little maybe around the bear here, but it's not bad. But there's something right here. Moved our bear here. We've got some more glue down here. Messed up. Okay. Still got a little bit of something right here I want out. And then this one is ready. gotta get this hunk right here. And then this baby's cleaned up. There we go. And now they're all finished except for drying for a while. And as soon as they dry for a while, then we can pull the pins off and these babies are done. Okay, I think they're probably dry enough to take the pins off now. Let's check it out, especially this side. This is the medium one. And this looks pretty flush. Doesn't look like it's moving much. There we go. There's the medium one. Now let's check out our big one. It's pretty sturdy. Pin stuck a little bit, which means there's some glue right here that needs to come off. But it doesn't really want to. It looks like it's pretty well good there. So now we'll pull off this side. Looks pretty sturdy there too. And there is our large one. So there the two of them are. We'll take this silicone mat out now because they're glued pretty good. And there are our two hair barrettes. So there are our hair barrettes. This is our large one. This is our medium one. There they both are. Didn't they turn out cute? I really love these. They really are pretty. And I hope you enjoyed making these with me. Now, I didn't get these pieces from any particular places. I always look in any place I find that we're going to see if there's any filigree pieces. Those are our background pieces. I really like those. And then, of course, the all of the little bits and pieces are, I find those all over the place too. But generally, I buy those on Etsy from, well, she closed her shop because, from health reasons, Time&Materials, where I normally get them from. But I'm hoping to find a substitute for her because I really do like her piece, the brass pieces. They really turn out nicely. As you can see, I normally paint them. I get in a painting mood and just paint all kinds of things. But yeah, I think these turned out really pretty. They are one of them is a custom order because I had one of my customers ask me for something with bears. And I made the large and the medium so she'd have her choice of which one she'd want. But I think they turned out gorgeously. So this has been Rose from In Rose's Garden, and we'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.